वेलकम, दिस इज मिस्टर संतोष लुकारे फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड कंट्रोल इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाजास कर्मवीर ॲडव्होकेट बाबूराव गणपतराव ठाकरे कॉलेज ऑफ इंजिनियरिंग. इन दिस सेशन वील डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉम्पेन्सेटर बेसिक्स. आउटलाइन ऑफ दिस सेशन, फर्स्ट वील डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, देन द आउटकम्स, इंट्रोडक्शन टू द कॉम्पेन्सेटर, compensator configuration, and which are the different commonly used compensators. Objectives: the objective of this session is to know the basics about the compensator. Outcomes: at the end of this session, students are able to understand and define the compensator and also able to classify the compensator. But before going to the actual compensator basics, we'll discuss about the feedback control system, or we'll just revise about the feedback control system. So this is the block diagram of the feedback control system, where G of S is the plant, H of S is the feedback, which will take care about the measurement of the output of the system or the plant, and R of S is my set point or the desired input, which is compared with the actual output of the plant, C of S. So this feedback control system, without any necessary adjustments or the modifications, will not provide the desired or the optimum performance. So in a control system, the proper modifications of the plant dynamics are required in order to get the desired performance from the plant. The desired performance specifications, you may say the response specifications, in time domain we can call it as a transient response specifications or the steady state response specifications for the applied step input. So if you consider the transient response specification, that desired specification, it could be the peak overshoot or the minimum peak overshoot. So in order to have such a desired performance specifications, we need to give the proper settings to the control system. In automatic control system, second year instrumentation and control, we have discussed about the root locus method, in which we have discussed the effect of open loop gain change on the closed loop stability of the system. So if we adjust the root locus of the given system, we can have the adjusted, or you may say the desired response from the control system. So in many practical situations, the plant G of S is fixed and it is not modifiable. Then we have to do the adjustment other than the fixed plant, or we have to adjust the closed loop system in a such a way that the desired performance is obtained from the plant, but we can't change the plant. So it is required to reconsider the structure of the system, and we have to redesign the system. So we can consider the feedback control system with some additional component. So here the problem becomes the problem of improving the system performance by inserting a certain subsystem into the main system, and that subsystem is called as a compensator. So what is compensator? Basically, a compensator is an additional component or the circuit other than the plant, which is inserted into the control system to improve the plant performance, to equalize the plant performance, or to remove some deficiency which are present in the original plant's response. So what is the necessity of the compensation, or why compensators are required? So the compensators are required if our original system is unsatisfactory in terms of the following. So my original system or the plant is having some stability issues, the speed of response is not as per the requirement, the plant may provides the large steady state error, and therefore my design of the system, it needs to be changed. So that design, it could be obtained in terms of the change in the frequency response or the body plot diagram or the root locus of the system in order to get the desired performance from the closed loop system. These performance measures are measured in terms of time domain, and those time domain specifications that we have already studied in second year automatic control system, that could be a peak time, the corresponding peak overshoot, then settling time for the step input, the steady state error for different kind of test inputs. So these performance specifications, it can be defined or that are provided in terms of the pole zero locations of the closed loop system. So here we need to adjust the closed loop poles and zeros location of the system in a such a way that if I apply the input, let us say the step input, for that step input my system will give me all the specification as per my expectation. Suppose I want the settling time of 4 seconds for the typical system, then I need to have some modifications into the system in a such a way that the closed loop response will provide me the 4 second settling time. So like that, we have to improve the performance of the system, or we have to adjust the system's performance specifications as per the desirable specifications in terms of its pole zero locations. So the root locus is one of the best method that can be used to find out the suitable compensator, let us say GC of S, so that the closed loop system will give you the desired performance in terms of all these specifications. So the compensator configurations. So the compensation scheme commonly used for the feedback control systems are, it could be a series compensator as shown in the figure. Now here we have considered the feedback control system with one more element, and that is GC of S. We can call it as a compensator. So my G of S is the plant, H of S is the feedback element, as we have seen in the previous slide. So GC of S is the compensator. So it is an additional component or the additional subsystem which is inserted into the main system or the feedback control system in order to improve the performance of the feedback control system. The second type of compensator that we can refer or we can use is the parallel compensation. So this GC of S element is there in parallel with the plant as shown in block diagram, that is G2 of S is in parallel with GC of S. So here you can say G2 of S and GC of S, they are in parallel. So the choice between this series and parallel compensator is depend upon the nature of the signals which are present into the system. So the nature of the signals, it could be a hydraulic, pneumatic, electrical, like that. The power levels at various points, the availability of the components in order to improve the performance of the system, and the designer's experience, and the last but not the least, an economic considerations, and many more. So the commonly used compensators are of the following type. It could be a lead compensator, lag compensator, or the lag lead compensator. Now we'll discuss about only the basic definitions of lead, lag, and lag lead compensator. So first is the lead compensator. Now what is compensator? That we have already discussed. So it is a kind of subsystem which can be inserted into the main system in order to improve the overall or the closed loop performance of the original plant. So if you consider such a subsystem, let us say GC of S, and if the sinusoidal input is applied to the network, then under steady state the output is also a sinusoidal one, it has a phase lead, then the network is called a lead network. So if I consider the phase lead network, if I apply the sinusoidal input with certain frequency and let us say the peak to peak voltage, then the same compensator will provides me the again sinusoidal wave as output with some peak to peak voltage and the same frequency, but there is a difference between the input and output in terms of time, and that difference is called as a phase difference. So if the output waveforms lead the input waveforms by some phase angle, then such a network is called as a phase lead network. In case of lag compensator, again if I apply the input, that is a sinusoidal input, in steady state the output is also a sinusoidal one, but which has the phase difference, that is lagging phase difference with respect to the input, then the network is called as a lag network. And the lag lead compensator is a kind of lag as well as the phase lead compensator, which occurs in the different frequency regions in terms of the frequencies. The phase lag occurs in the lower frequency region and the phase lead occurs in the high frequency region. So commonly used compensators are of electronic types, or you can call it as electronic networks or the electronic compensators, which includes the electronic components like operational amplifiers with other elements, let us say resistor, capacitor. Second type of the compensator is the electrical RC networks. Third one is the mechanical type of compensators with mass, spring and damper system. Further, our discussion is based on lead, lag and lag lead compensators, which are realized by the electrical elements, or you may say the electrical networks like resistor, inductor and capacitive networks as per the syllabus. So here these are the references, and thank you for listening.